Hey Nicole, it's Brian from Toofab here. Thank you so much for talking to us today about the 25th anniversary of Baywatch. Can you believe that it's been that long?
I mean, yeah, it feels like a lifetime ago. It's kind of scary how fast time flies, but it does seem like a lifetime ago.
Now, do you remember what your first day on set was like? The, you know, the first time you put that red bathing suit on?
Well, you know, what's interesting is when I was hired, I was too young to be an actual lifeguard in the show. So I was a rookie and I was in lifeguard in training. So my first season, it was a black Speedo bathing suit. So it wasn't as bad. It was a little more covering, but I had to do a lot more athletic work. I had to do a lot more, you know, it's training stuff and races and, you know, that sort of stuff. So it was a little bit harder physically, but I didn't get that red swimsuit till a little bit later.
So once you finally did get the bathing suit, was that like a, now I feel like I finally made it onto Baywatch moment?
No, I knew I was on Baywatch. I knew I was there. The difference is that the red one, you have a lot more like nip slips. It falls off the shoulder a lot easier. You know, the training one is a Speedo and the red one can easily pop off.
I've heard you talk about the weight clause before. Can you kind of explain what the heck that was all about?
Well, it, you know, there was a 5-pound weight clause, but I think that for the most part, everybody being in their bathing suit every day, all day, I don't think anybody really became an issue. In fact, it got me to start working out, but you know, it sort of taught me, you know, the workout ethic. But they also had 3 trucks for catering every day, so they were, it was a little, you know, just like, haha.
So how close were you guys on set? I know in the past you've talked a little bit about some of the tensions.
Yeah, I think, especially I did the first 2 seasons, I hear about things getting really competitive and catty between the women later. You know, we were all very different from each other and played such a different role, so we weren't competitive on screen or off screen. And I think later when they had more of these voluptuous, beautiful lifeguards, I think things got a little catty.
All right, so we're asking everyone to finish this sentence for us. The most surprising thing I've done since Baywatch is?
Have 2 children. Oh, I have a 16-year-old, and then I have 1 that just turned 3.
So have you shown Baywatch to your 16-year-old yet?
She just doesn't, she's just not really interested. No, she, yeah, she'll watch something if it's something I just did recently, like if she, you know, it's like she's been in my life. But, you know, I think maybe it's a little odd for her to watch me pretending to be somebody else. She's kind of just like, what is this? What are you doing? You know? And, you know, she loves me just being her mom. So, not really, you know, being an actress. The little one, on the other hand, gets so excited. It's really, she gets super, super excited. So they're very different from each other.
And last but not least, do you have any message for all the Baywatch fans still out there?
Just thank you. Thank you for supporting the show. Thank you for giving us all a great life and having a good time and enjoying the campiness, you know, along with us and us not taking ourselves too seriously.
Thanks, Nicole. It's been great talking to you today.
Thank you.